Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Gus, and there's Kublai, and there's a bunny.
Bunny rabbit? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I want to show them the bunny rabbit.
Show them
I was
the bunny
looking
rabbit.
At something else. Damn it. Look at this bunny. I just... So articulate. So beautiful. And you can see that it survived great, great travesties.
Such majesty.
Such majesty and gorgeous. I don't know what happened to this eye, though, or this eye. Maybe one of these eyes is better than the other eye? I'm not entirely sure. Yeah. Either way, I forgot to set the timer, so I'm gonna set that right now. Yeah.
And the first thing we do besides Bunny is loading screen.
Loading screen. That's just how much we love you guys. We just started. It's like, oh, forgot the timer. Oh, loading screen.
And your sweet Super Saiyan hair.
Oh my super! I'm very proud to be at University of Washington colors right now. It's the gold and purple. I bet anything
he's sleeping off a hangover. It's like Saints Row.
Oh yeah. The sound of some VAR kids burning alive at the same time ought to do it. You got a fire gun, right? Boop.
What we got here?
Alright, timer is now set. Apparently I set it for 5 minutes from now because I can math. There we go. There's the good math. Bam. Alright, so, Gus, I wanted to ask that question of you, which is that since you just had...
I prefer boxers.
You know, you're not as... I can't melt this free. You can melt this and shoot off its head.
He has a bow. He has a gun in his head.
Yeah. Good
hunting. I never knew that was a thing.
Well, me neither. But I just am that kind of person, I guess. Oh my God! I have a fire weapon. That's a snowman. I should shoot it. And then it didn't melt, and I was disappointed. And then it gave me a grenade mod. Sight. So anyway, wait. I wanted to ask you a question about your show that you did. And I wanted to find out what's the kind of the feeling of doing a live show.
Okay, so for those that don't know, I think we talked about it before, but I'm in a band called Mars Royal. And we had our first show on, if this comes out today, which it probably will, because it's Monday. We had it on Saturday. Also, don't. We gotta come over here and don't kill them, just burn them. I don't have a fire weapon, so this is all you. I will kill that one, though. The barkers won't make that screeching noise so, unless you burn them. I just
kill them?
Yeah. You just gotta burn them, like, make them catch on fire. Now, but they will burn very quickly. I think after a while.
I burn very quickly.
Let me, let's try something here. Ow.
I think your strategy is not as effective as you originally planned.
Not really. I'll get up. Back,
bitches. Kill revive. So there's a button here that sets fire.
Yep.
That sounds exactly like something I would love to play
more.
With.
One more. Yeah, burn two more. Because I can't do it. I don't have a fire weapon. I'm gonna kill the adult pods because those are jerks.
I'm having trouble killing these.
There we go. Okay.
All right. Very good. I don't know if I've really done this mission, to be entirely honest.
We're meeting Roland's spy.
Oh!
You might remember.
I do remember this guy.
From Borderlands 1.
Oh, fuck yeah. This dude. And his BFF Bloodwing. Oh, yeah. So loud.
So angry.
So angry.
So spice.
So dead.
Are we talking about birds?
Wait.
Music.
Music, yes. We were talking about music.
Yeah, I've been playing live performances for a while. It's just been about 3 years since I did one.
Right.
Because I played for 5 years in a metal band called Horns quite a while ago.
So,
I left them in...
The question that I was looking for is because so I've never done live music in my life. I've done some live shows, but I've never played like got up on a stage and played. I've only like would play guitar for friends or family or whatnot. So I wanted to know what that experience is like. Like, when you're looking at a bunch of people you don't know, when you're
that kind of thing. It definitely depends on the kind of music and the venue you're playing.
Gotcha.
With Horns, most of what we would play would be, like, bars where people weren't always interested in the band. They just show up for the drink, and then bands are playing that night.
Right.
So, we never had a whole lot of good crowd reactions when we played then.
You were just sort of there.
Yeah. Because being a particularly a progressive thrash metal band in the Bible Belt.
Interesting choice.
You don't get a lot of diehard fans. I mean, we had a few, but
honestly, I'm imagining just like, I'm trying to come up with the most ridiculous initial thing about like abort your babies, kind of death metal style is what keeps coming to mind. I know that's not you, but that's just what came to mind.
We did play with a death metal band once called Murder Boner.
Nice.
So Tina's a bomb. They were actually really nice.
Well, in my experience, it seems like most people into death and thrash are really chill.
Yeah, there's a lot. We met a lot of really nice people playing in that band. So,
yeah.
The biggest show we ever did was a Battle of the Bands for about 80 people.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
And what's funny was that we were the only even slightly heavy band. Like, every other band was like an acoustic duo or like light indie alternative rock. And then we just go up. We're like the second band of the night. And I have like 8-minute progressive thrash songs and stuff.
Oh, that's awesome.
And we got third out of eight or nine bands.
Well done. That's pretty awesome. Hey, I just found something that says to murder is human, to forgive divine. If you're hearing this, you just
killed me. And let me just say, no hard feelings. Before you wasted me, I kept my best guns in my garage. Considering how badass you must be to have blown me away, I'd say you deserve them. I know this sounds like some sort of trap, but you're just gonna have to trust me.
Okay, let's go to the trap.
We'll go do that then.
Yeah. No hard feelings.
Yeah. But I think the biggest thing about playing music, for me at least, is because I'm a drummer, I don't actually see the crowd a whole lot.
Oh, that's because you're sitting in the back, or?
I'm in the back behind two or three people. And I'm looking down at my drums most of the time. So it's not often I would look up and see the crowd. Especially in the smaller places, we have to cram all of us on stage together.
Right. Gotcha. I always, my experiences. Have you ever seen the film, I think it's called That Thing You Do? It's about
No, I haven't.
Gosh, it's with Liv Tyler. It was her first film she was ever in. And, it's about this band that gets super popular really quick. And, hey, this significantly less of a trap than I expected. Trap! Oh. Nobody
kills me and gets away with it. You were saying?
I got away with it. That must have hurt. And now.
Dang, you heard the
freezing. Anyway, Liv Tyler. Whoa, they're freezing.
They have hats.
That's cool. Are you guys super cold?
Let it go.
What was that?
Let it go.
Let it go. Let it
go.
Something anymore. What'd you get? You suck. Wait, was that my shield?
Yeah.
Oh. I thought we just picked up another talking gun. I was like, I don't remember losing a talking gun. Gotcha. That was pretty legit. Good little experience to go off and do. No hard feelings, man.
Anyway, Liv Tyler movie?
Yes. So it was called That Thing You Do. And it was about a band that got popular really fast. And during this process, it kind of deals a lot with like what happens when a band becomes super popular. And they had a guy named Shades who was their drummer. And Shades just kind of like wore some sunglasses once on the back while playing. And it became his thing. And so they would always, since he became one of the most popular people on it, they would always have him on a raised platform when he was drumming. So it was very easy to see Shades. Mm-hmm. And so whenever I think of, I keep shooting anything that looks explosive and nothing happens. I'm somewhat disappointed.
Well, don't. Are you shooting these things here?
Yes.
Well, get closer. Don't just shoot it. You gotta go up to it.
Oh. Oh, okay. It's proximity based.
Yep. Taking the shot. They really don't do a whole lot of damage.
They do not, but they are terrifying when you don't realize what's about to happen.
Yeah. Also, if I remember correctly, the damage doesn't scale, so when you're back here at, like, level, like, 50 or 60, it still only do, like, 200 damage.
Wow.
Like, how much... I don't even think it'll take me down if I just stand right next to it. Nope. Doesn't even take my shields all the way down. It doesn't even be 300.
I've never met Tiny Tina, ever.
Well, now you will. You'll either love her or hate her. There's like no one between.
This is the guy's sister, the writer of Borderlands 2. This is his sister voicing this character.
Yep.
I can totally recognize. Hey, Ash. General Rancid. So you gotta hijack a train, huh? Child crap. Let me introduce you to my ladies. There was a whole theory that I'm actually her dad.
Yeah.
Oh, look, the bunny rabbit!
Yep. Tina drew it.
Oh, it's her thing. Well, I'm very proud of your drawings, daughter. Sexo pants. My ass women could stop that train for you, but I'm gonna need their badonkadonks
first. And they got stole by the bandits a few days ago. Go get them! They got stole by the bandits?
Nap time!
I do have a... Tina can be odd, but she's the most gifted demolitions expert. She's kind of floating a little bit there. Just do what she asks, and I guarantee she'll... God, her head is... Stop waking her up. She's trying to get her beauty sleep. Nap time. I got nothing for you. She also floats.
Just a little bit. Nah, man. No new jobs,
please. Also, I have something that might ruin your theory.
Yeah. It's not mine. I've just heard it.
Yeah, that theory. Yeah. She has some stuff set up here for a tea party.
Yeah.
And her guests. So if you want to come over and read the... the seating cards. You can see who's all invited to the party.
Princess Fluffy Butt, Lady Tina of Plumbenfrog, Sir Reginald von Bartleby, and evil bastard that killed my parents. I'm assuming he's going to be in the electric box?
Yep. Lady Tina of Blow Up Your Faceheim.
Oh.
So...
Very good name.
Tina actually does have a pretty sad backstory.
I mean, her parents getting destroyed?
Yeah.
I would imagine that could still be me, though. Simply based on the fact that, he was not dead, but you're kind of
thing. But he was driven insane.
Yeah, exactly.
Because he...
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. What was I talking about? Hi, Tina.
Oh, wait, so now she's just awake.
Oh, man, Well, let's go do the thing.
Oh, wait, I have a reward to return. I don't know why.
What do you have to do?
I have a reward that I'm returning right now.
A reward?
Yeah, mission complete. No hard feelings. Oh, yeah, right. Go to your menu.
Oh, from the, Yeah, you didn't open your inventory since you got a choice of weapons.
Right. I'm going to choose that one. And... Let's compare that to that.
I found money.
I think I'm just going to go off that this gun is more expensive. Fast bullets? Rockets? What the hell is this gun? Oh, wow. It shoots explosions. And reloads slower than turtle.
God. Slower than turtle.
Slower than turtle. Marcus Mutiny. I'm gonna try out Explodey Gun. Hey, look, there's a picture of her and Roland. A really cute picture of her and Roland.
Is they friends?
Oh. I could definitely see there being a little bit of a father, complex there. Roland would absolutely be a good person for that, too. Like, I could see him as an individual be like, yeah, I would like to help her.
Yeah. Huh. Alright, let's go get the badonkadonks.
The badonkadonks. I am an ass man, as you are, so I think this is a good idea.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, have you seen the the Dr. Pepper rap song that came out recently? It's just like,
I was unaware of this.
So it's this woman singing about getting Dr. Pepper, and it's, oh god, I didn't mean to do this. Oh well.
There's enemies right here. Run, my child. Slaughter them all.
I must make friends. Make friends. You are my best friends.
Here, read him.
Wow, that was, there was not enough of them to make me feel good.
There's more over here.
Oh.
Busted makes me feel good.
See, how's this gun working? Huh. It's not working very well. It's alright. I don't think he liked me.
What were we talking about?
Badonkadonks, I believe.
Oh, I think wrong thing. Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper, right. Specifically because this music video just has a ton of butts in it, and they're just singing about Dr. Pepper, and it's kind of a weird combination of things to, like, be watching. It's just Dr. Pepper and butts.
Like Dr. Pepper and, like, twerking?
Yeah. Well, not twerking, but butts. Like, they're like, bouncing to the music, and they're just like, this is a butt, and this is also a butt. And I'm trying to remember for the life of me what it was. Like, I was watching this other one, it's like, I think you're freaky. Like, think, not I think you're freaky. It's like, I just, all these ridiculous music videos that were popping up in my life. They're just terrible and scary and very interesting in a way, like, because music videos are supposed to be, our timer just went up, but I'm gonna finish this subject and we're gonna shoot some people. But it's like, music videos are supposed to be advertisements for whatever the, God bless you. For whatever you're supposed to look for. Like, let me phrase that. Whatever you're trying to sell. So, you know, selling song, you know, whatever kind of, whoa, I almost got hit by a train.
It will kill you.
Whoa, that was close.
Yeah.
All right. Uh-oh. I'm summoning bandit reinforcements right now.
Why you do this?
I just saw a turn thing and I pressed the button.
Oh, I'm the...
I think you're freaky just... and I like you a lot. Anyway, that song stuck in my head.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're freaky and I like you a lot.
Is that the butt song?
No, that's not the butt song. The Dr. Pepper song is the butt song. And it's also pretty interesting, because but it was also just like I think you're freaky was like kind of a cool song. I
remember hearing that. Wasn't that popular a few years ago?
It might have been. I'm pretty slow in the whole music thing.
Yeah.
It's but it's like in the case of yes, burn for me, friends. But in the case of like, the Dr. Pepper song, it just wasn't good to me. It was like, and but my whole point was like, if they're trying to sell musical records, it's good to have, like, music videos that are just really ridiculous and memorable. Mm-hmm. Because you want to try to get across the experience of the music and to get people interested in remembering and buying your music at a later time.
Yeah.
And so it's like it's a branding thing. And so it's really weird for me to hear Dr. Pepper in this, because it's like they must have asked Dr. Pepper if it was okay for them to do this brand deal and like sing and talk about butts and stuff. But it just seems so non-Dr. Pepper to me.
Like, so was it an official Dr. Pepper video?
Probably
not.
Did
Dr. Pepper make it, or did someone just make it and sang about Dr. Pepper?
Probably that, and had to pay them to like have access to their brand name. But it's just, and my hope is that it's about some terrible drug that, like, makes your eyes turn yellow and, like, fall out and come back in when you wake back up after, like, something. But it's like, it just didn't, like, because it just did not feel like a good use of the Dr. Pepper brand.
Yeah.
Which I bring up because it's like, that's what I've done in a lot of my career stuff, was just marketing.
Drink Dr. Pepper.
I don't really drink soda, man. It's not for me. Oh god, why am I standing on the train track? Just asking for death. Alright. This last person? Any more bandits?
No, I think we're good. Alright,
we're good? Okay, we can end it now. Alright, dudes, if you liked what you saw or drink Dr. Pepper, like, Or, you know, fuck it. You can dislike it, if you don't like Dr. Pepper. Because Dr. Pepper may not be your thing. But I recommend that you try things that you've never liked before. Because maybe you like them again. Life moral at the end of Borderlands 2. Try
the more
shit.
You know. Life moral. Try Dr. Pepper. Get addicted to it. Submit yourself to Peepsy.
Submit to Peepsy. That's a Game Grumps reference. Am I getting it?
Yes.
Yes. Good show. Good show, man. Nothing wrong with that. And the beginning of next episode, I'm going to talk about how I actually used Game Grumps in my daily life.
I saw Dan at RTX.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, wow. You kind of have this action pose right now. Oh, we need a fight. Do you want to fight up here? Like, on this?
Should we do it here or should we do it on the train track?
Oh, God, no. That would.
Let's do it here.
Yeah. I'll show you how to fight. All right. Count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fight!
Ah, fucking butts. So was I! You.
Woo!
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I can heal you.
Wait, did you just heal me? Thank you. Yeah, wait, did you? What I meant is, like, did you heal me in that fight?
Ammo. I don't think so.
Okay, good.
I think. Yeah, the more powerful a gun I use, the more it heals you.
Gotcha. Alright, dudes. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. And of course, Gus's buddies, thank you for coming by. We love you. Alright, see you later, everybody. Bye. Woo!